I'm bored, you're bored. Let's get this over with. Well, look who's here. New recruits? Well, let's fuck some shit up.
Wait, see the future? What are you talking about? I can see the future. Well, at least possible outcomes. At least that's what my purpose was before. Before Rose came along and showed us a different way. Wait, so, can we talk about this later? The cold is really starting to... Oh, right! Sapphire, can you come with us? I see no reason not to. As soon as they get back to Inko's place, Izuku has a crazy amount of questions. Mainly, so what's this about seeing the future? I can see possible outcomes depending on the situation or what events take place. Think of it like you deciding to have pizza or french fries. Huh? Wait. Hold on, just hear me out. Depending on which future correlates with whatever you eat, can help me make a decision on which future is going to be, like what's going to happen next. That's cool, but also sounds kind of scary. A little haunting. What do you mean? I mean, you sound like you, you seem like you take it very well, but I can't imagine seeing so many outcomes pretty much hinging on a single action. Or a complete, and total series of actions. My Uncle Night Eye, he can see the future, but not like that. Really? That's interesting. You have more questions, don't you? Well, yeah, I would like to know more about my mom, definitely. Well, besides starting a war with her home planet, she rallied all the gems that, like, also she had this kind of charismatic air around her. For some reason, we just felt like following her, even though moments before we were enemies, or just regular gems. We couldn't really explain it, but it felt like we were supposed to. It felt right following her orders, and whenever we lost someone, it's like she felt it too. No one could really explain it. Yes, I do have this ability, even I couldn't predict what would happen completely. So many possibilities, so many actions that would have to be taken for this to happen. It's It was a lot. But I would always keep my cool, so to speak. At least when she was around. My mom? No. Ruby. Whenever she was around me, I felt like I could do anything. I would like to see her again. I'm sorry, but I don't know where Ruby is. Yeah. You said that. And apparently you don't know where Pearl or Amethyst is either, but I'm sure they're fine. Right? Yeah, sure. I don't see why not. Hey, how about this? We can go exploring, though we can't use the warp pads. Why? Oh, okay, I see why. So, heck, why don't you show me what they look like? Can you draw? I can try my best. What? As tears start flooding down Izuku's face. No. I'm sorry. Wait, what? What are you talking about? Why are you sorry? It wasn't supposed to happen. They weren't supposed to. They got in the way. I wasn't fast enough. Izuku, please tell me. As Inko walks in, those look like. Did you say those were the shattered gems you saw in your dreams? What? Shattered? Yeah, he said. In his dream, he saw them. Who are they? As Sapphire starts crying, but then icicles start forming as the whole area around her starts to freeze over. Izuku's. They were very important people. That's impossible. We would have never. If we were together. Why weren't we together? Damn it! Why can't? I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. No, it's fine. You're going through some tense emotions right now. Keep talking. It makes no sense for me and Ruby. We were inseparable. There was no way for her to be without me, and me without her. It's unthinkable. How did this happen? Why? How come I didn't see it? Why can't healing powers, do you have any? Yes or no? Can you heal? Yeah, my spit is like, no, don't. That's wrong. You should have healing tears. What? Yeah, that's what your mom would do. Okay, so What? That's how she would heal us. I mean, I don't remember ever healing a shattered gem before, but whenever our gems would get damaged, cracked, or so, she could always fix it, and she would, and we'd be good as new, like nothing even happened. We had to find her. We had to find Ruby. We had to find them. We will. I promise. I am so sorry. I did not know. No, it's not your fault. You just... Izuku didn't know who they were. You sure didn't. But there's still a connection there. Between you and your mom. It's memories. Somehow, maybe... That's it. Maybe that's how we can find them. What? Yeah, but I'm seeing too many roads in which we die. I get shattered. You losing your gem, and wait, what happens if I? You don't want to know. So many possibilities. I see so many deaths. So many ways things could go wrong. If we're not careful, if we misstep once, I could... Sapphire. What? Please calm down. Take a deep breath. We don't need to breathe. Well, do it anyway. Try to relax. And just imagine how happy everyone will be once they're reunited with us. But what about homeworld? What? I see them. That is inevitable. I can see them coming here. No, that's impossible. Lapis, what? Wait, you've seen a Lapis Lazuli? Well, yeah, she was trapped in a mirror. I let her out. Why? Because she was trapped, and No, you. Are you crazy? They are designed for terraforming planets thanks to their water-based abilities. They help prepare a world for colonization, and you let one escape. We had an agreement that she's a homeworld gem. I sure as hell don't remember having any friends that were Lapis Lazuli. She's my friend. Her gem was cracked. I healed it so she could fly again. Oh my god. He's so cool. Then she's definitely made it to homeworld. And if she tells anyone about you, me, there's gonna be utter hell rain down on Earth. But we have quirks here, yes, and they have a army of near indestructible soldiers, technicians, spaceships that can destroy. You shouldn't have let her go. You should have kept her in that mirror. No. I trust Lapis. I think that trust might get us killed. As well as this whole planet. You can't just blindly trust people you just met. That's funny. I trusted you. You know me. At least your mom did. And her memories are stuck in your head. Or Jim, or wherever. Deep down inside, you know me, and you knew you could trust me. As far as I can tell, you should have just... What? Left her trapped? Shattered? Lapis? Maybe. I still won't believe in Lapis. Well, let's hope your belief was not misplaced. Because as far as I can tell, Homeworld is still coming here. At least someone is. At the very least, we need to prepare, just in case. But I need Ruby. We need Garnet. Amethyst and Pearl. Wait, Garnet? Who's Garnet? Don't worry. It's just a friend. A close friend. Okay. So, do you know the location of any other temples that we could follow? Any leads you might have? Yeah, but to get to some of the places where we need to go, we're going to need warp pads. No. What? No, we can't risk using the warp pads and alerting Homeworld to our presence. It's too late. They're already coming here. Yes. But you say that's just a possibility. That's set in stone regardless. But what if we could change that? What? By using the warp pads, that could solidify them coming here. Okay. Say this Lapis was trustworthy. Say she didn't betray you. Then how come I keep seeing Homeworld coming here? I don't know. Maybe knowing the future isn't such a good thing. What? You heard me. Maybe your power isn't such a good thing after all. Have you ever heard of a self-fulfilling prophecy? What are you trying to say? All I'm saying is, maybe sometimes you need to keep our future a secret. Or ignore it. I can't ignore it. Do you know how much this pains me to know what could happen if this goes down? If you eat that, if you step on this, it is a lot to process. It's like, how do I describe it? like these strings connected to me. Only thing is, there's so many of them that I can't fully pinpoint where to go. I don't know what's gonna happen if I'm just trust me, Sapphire. Can you do that? I trusted Rose. And now Ruby is gone. I don't know if I can trust you.